It's a gorgeous day here in Southern California, and today we're going to take out our RJ Walsh Mini RS Dog Sulky. This is the newest and lightest sulky that Jim Walsh in Australia makes. It's only 28 pounds, and all stainless steel construction, has 26-inch racing tires. We're also going to be taking along our Porty Power flag made by Dud's Gear in New Jersey, complete with a cluster of jingle bells on the end of the tip to ward off stray dogs should we encounter any. We've got Chuckie and Gladys on as our dog power today. Chuckie and Gladys are a couple of 3.5-year-old Portuguese water dogs, brother and sister. And Chuckie and Gladys work very well together, as you'll see, and are always interested in getting out and going karting. So with this, we're going to get on the road. We're getting ready to get up onto the paseos. We're traveling down my street, and I'm only a block and a half away from the beginning of the paseos, and Valencia has 26 miles of paseos that are just perfect for dog karting. And it's a nice cool day, so Gladys and Chuckie are all raring to go. We haven't been out in a couple of days. You can see that they get all jazzed whenever we pass a house that's got dogs that barks at us. This is part of the things they enjoy as we're karting. We're gonna get up on the paseos now. Now we're out on the paseos, and you can see that they're working well together.
That's so awesome!
Thank you! We're approaching our tunnel. The tunnel has speed bumps, so we have to go carefully in the RS so we don't take them too hard. In the city mini we fly through here, we get some air. Whoa! Okay, let's run! We just came out of the tunnel, so now we're getting ready to proceed on down into the big park. Okay, let's go. Hike! Hike! Let's go! Here we are, coming through the paseo. We're going to go straight to it this time. Chuckie, on by. On by. Good! Good boy. We frequently go left there, so sometimes the dogs get into quite a habit of going one particular direction. This is a really nice park, and you can see that they have just spotted a squirrel. And, whoa, we're off into the bushes. So, normally I would not allow them to do this, but I cannot rein and take pictures at the same time. Well, that was fun. The problem with taking pictures is that I can't rein with one hand. So normally what I would have done is hold them in and we would have stayed on the sidewalk, but not with the camera in one hand. So they got a little chance, and the squirrel was sitting right there on the ground looking at them, so it was just too much to resist. This particular bridge that goes over a large street is rather steep, so if I have all four dogs, I'll have them pull me up here, but when I'm only taking two, let's go, hike! I get out and walk. If you don't, then your dogs tire quickly. We've just crossed over the bridge, and now we're getting ready to get on our way. Let's go, hike! Everybody, whoa, let's not run over the people. Okay, let's go, let's go. Again, we have the problem of not being able to rein and take movies at the same time. Just need one more hand. The RS sits a lot lower, so you get a very different perspective. You also have to be watching out for dogs and people because you're down more at the level. On the City Mini, you're up higher so you can see what's going on a little further. But down here, you're a lot closer to the ground, which is good. You can put your feet down, but it does limit your view. Let's go, right? Yeah, nothing like a chase. Thank you. Squirrels, so Chuckie's already anticipating that and picking up the pace all on his own. This is a nice section of trail in here. The dogs are enjoying it, even though it's just a little bit of an uphill. And I always pick up the pace when we go by dogs in the yards where they have other dogs in them. So he gets excited, especially Chuckie gets all wound up. And we're moving along at a nice pace, about 9 miles, oops, hit the grass there, about 9 miles an hour, which is pretty easy for them, even going uphill, and just the two of them pulling me. It's just got a little steeper here, and we have another squirrel, Chuckie, on by. Good. That's usually what happens when you see the squirrels. He gets all excited and looks around, but he channels it into pulling a little bit harder and faster. So everybody has fun. I enjoy the speed, and they enjoy the squirrel. By the way, I know what our speed is because I have a speedometer and odometer, cat eye, on the cart. Here we are at our halfway point. This is a church up at Tournament Road, which is about halfway on our usual runs of about 3 miles. Is about a mile and a half into our run. And the people here are real nice. They let us stop and use their facilities and get a drink of water and rest a little bit while we're taking a breather halfway through. I usually take advantage of being here to do a few little exercises off the cart. Chuckie, left. Chuckie, left. Left. Good. Good. Ho. Ho. Right. Circle right. Right. Good. Ho. Ho. Now I'm going to put them on a stay and ask them to come as I walk away. Get a little closer here. Okay, come! Ho. 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 Perfect! Come. Chuckie, come. Ho, ho. Very good, ho. Stay. That was very good, you guys. We usually spend a couple minutes here giving the dogs a chance to rest and catch their breath. They also get their water bottle or their water bowl, and then they get some extra treats while we're here. This is our halfway point. We're going to be doing 3 miles today. So this is a church up at the way up at the freeway by our house, and it'll be a little bit of a downhill all the way home. So hopefully we'll be going a little faster than we did coming out, which I can see by my speedometer was about 13 miles an hour was our high speed. Okay, walk on. We like to take advantage of walkways and different types of terrain and sidewalks to practice our turns and having the dog learn to navigate these different paths and different widths of walkway on their own. Hi. And take advantage of everything we can at the malls and take the sidewalks and the posts that go through. We're going to take a section of street here. We can go all the way home on the paseos, but sometimes it's nice just to take a little bit different route, and especially in the daytime when we know we can be seen. And so we parallel our route that we came out, but just take a side street with not too much traffic on it, nice and wide. People can go around us and they can see us clearly. It's also good for the dogs to get used to the traffic, since definitely we're doing most of our carting in the city. We're in one of the many parks here in Valencia that has one of the tot lots, so we have a lot of families with children that are out here playing on the in the equipment. So we're going to just cart through here and make a right before we get to the street. Hopefully the dogs will know where we're going, because I really can't rein. Hi. Let's go. Walk on, Chuckie. Yeah, they did that okay. We're starting back down on getting back on the paseos again for our ride home. And kids are picking up the pace. We're doing about 9.6 miles per hour. And as I said, this is a little bit of a downhill, so they usually go a little faster. Together. How about running together?
Yeah,
there we go. Oh, no, now they're up again. There we go. They eventually learn to gait together. And here's somebody with a dog passing. That went completely without incident. It was great. They just walked right on by. I've noticed that if the dog is between 10 and 20 feet away, that usually there's not a desire to bark. We're still working on getting rid of that. But it will take some time. Whoops.
Hi.
I'm sorry, I didn't see your dog there.
Okay.
Luckily, that was a little dog. For some reason, they don't seem to consider little dogs to be really dogs. Hour, which is a good pace for them. They can usually do this for quite a few miles. We're going back into the darker part of the trail again. By the way, each of the dogs are wearing belly bands, which is a piece of harness that you really can't see because it's black, but it is a girth strap that goes around the tuck of the dog behind the rib cage and then attaches to the front part of the harness and prevents the harness from being pushed forward when the cart stops, and it allows the dog to use his body to stop the cart when they're going on slight downhills or when he's asked to. One of the bridges, it goes over one of the main roads, and it's relatively steep, so I get out and just walk behind the cart and have the dogs pull it up by themselves. Walk on! Chuckie, walk on! Chuckie, walk on, go! He wasn't listening. We're over the bridge now and getting ready to start back through another park on our way home. All right, let's go, walk on. I just spotted a squirrel going up that tree over there, but luckily Chuckie didn't. So let's see if we can get through the park. Right, there we go. Okay, let's go, pick it up. Let's go. First it's right, now it's left. Left. We got a border collie that's got his head up over the top of the wall looking at us going by. Hi. And Gladys are still pulling hard, so we've been working very vigorously the last month getting in shape, so I think we're going to have a good winter. It's nice and cold. We're going to make another left and take another pasado, eventually working our way back home. We're moving along at a nice clip. This is not too difficult for them. And when things along the way rise up, they have no problem looking around and taking in the sights while we're going. We got all these little sharp things on the sidewalk that are really tough on their feet if they step on them, so I know they're picking their way through them. Stay left. Stay left. Right. Thank you. So look at the speedometer. I see we've done 2.5 miles. Here to cross the street. Let's go. We've crossed the street and now we're in the parking lot of the second church on our run. Actually, we're right behind our house. We're almost back home. And our house is right on the other side of that block wall. Portuguese water dogs. Okay, let's go. Let's go. Come on, hey! Sometimes they slow down when we go around a tight corner because they're waiting for me to tell them that the wheels have cleared, which is something they've learned throughout the years because they don't like having the wheels hit. Now we're on the sidewalk along McBean Parkway, left, and approaching the back of Granary Square, which is where we usually end up most of our dog runs. We stop there and have cookies and water. Sometimes I even get a coffee at Starbucks. Street where we would normally turn in to go home, so sometimes they want to take a shortcut and go home, but they didn't today. We get a lot of attention when we're driving along such a big, busy street. We get people that hang out the window sometimes and take pictures of us with their cell phones. Here we are. We like to practice in here because it's good for weaving in and out of tight areas. Oops, sorry. Let's go. We also have to be careful that we don't run over anybody as they're coming out the door. Left. Let's go. Final stop before we head off. An extra block and a half before we get home. We're gonna stop here and have a little water and some cookies. We're up here at Granary Square. This is where we usually stop. This is our last stop before we head on the next block and a half to go home. The kids are tired. We've done about 2.5 miles. And they're ready for their cookies and their last water stop. We've got quite a crowd here today watching us, and a lot of other dogs and people. And usually most people find the cart interesting and ask a lot of questions. We like to use this walkway here through the mall. We usually come through here when it's not so busy. It's good practice for the dogs to maneuver the cart around tighter areas and through a lot of distractions, including driving through a couple of restaurants, outdoor restaurants, and even a vet's office that often has dogs out in front. So. Left, left, left. Now we're on our home stretch here, back through the mall. Okay, let's go. That was a little close. We clipped the bolt on the wheel. All right, let's go. Hey. final straight hair, going along McKean Boulevard again on the sidewalk. We're gonna cut into the houses here to the left in just a second. Right. Okay. They know where they are, so it's usually kind of a brisk run home. Notice how the dogs have picked up the pace now that we're on our own straight. You can see that Gladys is really leaning into the harness on the right side. It doesn't take them long to be pulling into the driveway once we're this close. And here we are, back home.